kita akan rasa susah sangat, penat sangat. Apa yang kita belajar semua macam tak keluar.
You pernah masuk tak any macam emergency punya case ataupun sepanjang masih intern ataupun sekarang lah time master houseman?
Okay, the truth is kan, housemanship is when you deal with patient and always you are in charge untuk emergency. Always. Sebab kan, dia tak kira like if you start to work or not, once you start housemanship, you are already a doctor. So kan, it's very important for you to be prepared lah, mindset yang you akan face a lot of very, you will face things that you are not familiar with. You will take time to adapt to the unfamiliarity, and once you adapt, you get better, and then you gain your confidence. That's what housemanship is. Housemanship is actually a, dia memang betul-betul wake up call lah. So yang emergency yang I had go through, that I had gone through is like patient yang betul-betul macam collapse. So collapse means that patient betul-betul flat lah. So yang ED dia tengok kat like on the movies, yeah, it happened to me like on my second week dah. Some even first week, you know, depends on which department you go to. You have to do all that lah as doctor. Okay, as sad as it sounds, this is why we still have housemanship. We have seniors who will guide us. Kita ada MO. MO is the one actually in charge of the patient, and we are the one yang, sebab kita intern kan, we just carry out their plans. So the MO will help us, and also our senior houseman yang lain-lain pun will help us. So we won't be very lost. So based on my experience kan, actually kan, it's good tau kita orang share awal-awal macam ni, like this video. Sebab ramai orang bila ni dah habis, like they related, they entered like 1 year of housemanship, they will forget how it feels like to be a 1 month old houseman. So I will remember lah yang initially kan, masa kita masuk, kita akan rasa susah sangat, penat sangat. Apa yang kita belajar semua macam tak keluar. So kalau kat kelas lah kita belajar, wah okay, first, what is the question? Kita boleh part, list out everything what we supposed to do kan. That's how we study kan. Tapi bila kita jadi doktor kan, things are not like soalan yang dia bagi tau. Kita orang kena fikir apa soalan tu and jawapan dia. You know what I mean? It's not straightforward lah.
You kena orang kata connect apa benda dia punya problem dengan problem yang lain. So you nak tahu apa benda penyakit tu sendiri.
Penyakit, you nak tahu penyakit tu apa? It's not the hard part. The hard part is what you do with the penyakit, yeah, and the treatment and all that. Tapi the treatment plans are not by us lah, not by us. So houseman, we do like I said lah, macam earlier yang kita orang carry out apa MOB plans. Kalau dia nak suruh kita buat test for the patient, so contohnya kita ambil darah, itu kita kena buat. And then in ward kita kena make sure patient survive. So how kalau patient tu kena, katakanlah dia kena, kita orang kena pasangkan dia air tu, itu kerja kita, you know. And then IV, kita assist itu kat ward for example. And then we have to make sure that patient stable. I mean, we carry out the plans, and then if patient suddenly dia punya condition worse, dan kita orang kena alert the MO, because MO tak ramai, houseman ramai. So houseman yang akan carry out the daily plans lah. So houseman is like nurses in private practice, something like that. But depends on department, depends on hospital, houseman is allowed, yeah, allowed to make plans for the patient, tapi not serious plans. And then kalau houseman, kita orang pun akan pergi ke like operation room. Okay,
oh tengok intai.
Oh, kita tak tengok.
Oh, tak ada. Oh,
kita orang buat. Oh, I mean we assist.
Okay.
Kita orang akan assist. So contohnya kalau surgeon kita buat kerja, so houseman will be like the second eye atau second hand to help. So houseman, doktor, I mean surgeon, bukan doktor, kita pun doktor juga. So surgeon akan macam buat bedahan, pembedahan. Kita orang akan jadi dia punya team lah, macam support. So katakanlah dia nak, dia tengah potong, banyak darah keluar for example. Kita orang lah kena sedutkan darah tu. Kalau ada benda kotor, kita yang kena bersihkan, like kind of stuff.
Okay, sebab so, selalu macam boleh. Sebab so, selalu kalau macam tengok dekat K-drama and everything, selalunya akan ada doktor yang macam intern kat tepi. So usually yang tu kita tahu intern lah. Tapi kalau yang macam yang time Afla dulu intern, apa nama?
Ada.
So akan memerhati, itu yang geng-geng memerhati lah.
Okay, geng kita memerhati tu time kita medical school.
So waktu itu memang untuk student lah, sebelum diorang nak pilih mana yang diorang nak jadi, department mana dan apa semua tu.
So kalau jadi houseman, you akan masuk OT, we call it operation theatre, operating theatre, OT. So kita orang akan masuk sana, kita orang akan pakai scrubs, and then kita orang akan tolong lah, that's our job. Sebab Sebab kan housemanship is a training ground kan. So after houseman kita akan jadi MO.
So masa yang time yang nak tolong-tolong tu memang dah ada pengalaman kan, ataupun waktu memang time tu lah kita tahu nak pegang benda tu.
Okay, actually kat medical school kita orang, certain medical school will actually prepare you to be more equipped to join the workforce. Okay, so like my medical school, dia ada ajar, okay, this surgical tu nama apa, this surgical tu nama apa. And actually that time, wow, I find it very annoying. Macam kenapa kita nak tahu, you know what I mean? Because we are doctors, we do not need to know this. For example, this brush, apa nama dia, this, you know, this kind of stuff. So bila kita masuk operation theatre, baru kita faham kenapa it's penting. Sebab when you operating, you akan ada orang yang buat operation tu, and then you kena hand orang yang buat operation tu the tools. So that's why you have to know exactly the name of the tools. So it's actually very important. So selalunya yang buat surgery ialah MO. So that's why houseman kena assist, sebab one day houseman will be MO. And then MO will one day be a registrar and then be a specialist. Kan? So that's how the pathway is like. So that's why housemanship is very important. It provide you the training ground to learn. So we are doctors, tapi I wouldn't say we are safe to go out and practice in a private setting on our own. We still need macam mentor macam tu lah.
Alright, so last question lah, last question for the day. So daripada macam apa cerita tadi, daripada housemanship ke MO, MO ke specialist. So boleh Afa explain tak, selagi berapa lama tempoh daripada houseman ke MO, MO ke specialist?
Okay, actually I'm figuring that out. So nanti kalau kita buat new video, I will be more clear. Tapi right now, what I know of, housemanship is 2 years minimum. Okay, maximum 3 years maximum, I think. Okay, so 2 years of housemanship, lepas tu kita jadi MO. So during our MO, actually during our houseman pun, kita orang boleh take papers. Papers into what we want to specialize as. Sebab for us to be a registrar specialist kan, kita have to complete a certain number of papers dulu, baru kita boleh proceed to the next step. And also kan guys, gaji dia tak sama eh. Gaji registrar, gaji dengan MO, and gaji semua level tak sama. So the more higher in studies I guess you are, the higher is your pay. Yeah, so there are people daripada houseman, I mean I know of a doctor, from houseman to specialist is about 6 years. So memang itu sangat-sangat laju. No one can do that. Okay, only like it's very rare lah. So meaning that even during houseman yang busy-busy macam ni pun, dia tengah study buat paper. Tapi there are people who from houseman to specialist, I think it's most common is about 10 years lah. 10 to above 10 years lah.
So usually orang kata average umur untuk geng-geng specialist ni around 40. Paling-paling muda,
yeah,
pun
paling muda 40, 40 correct. Yeah. Ataupun maybe ada yang lagi muda, maybe 38.
Tu yang memang memang fast dia orang punya.
Fast, very ambitious, hardworking, yeah. The cream of the crop. Yeah. Sebab it's not easy to study, and like medical we all pun tahu kan, it's life and death kan. And then you have to treat your patient. Yeah, itulah.
Okay, alright. So sebagai penutupnya tu sajalah kita hari ini. Mungkin Afa nak say something to adik-adik ke, or any friends yang rasa nak continue in this kind of pathway as a doctor. Yeah.
I guess kan guys, if you have the intention to do it and no one ask you to do it, just you yourself want to do it, just go for it lah. Yeah. But if like someone else ask you to do it, then you have to reconsider your life's choices lah, because it's definitely not going to be easy. Your medical school pun tak easy, housemanship pun tak easy. And a lot of people say that housemanship will be the toughest. No, MO also not easy. So it's really not easy. Tapi for me lah, based on my experience, the job fulfillment is, I feel fulfilled lah, because every day we see different things, so memang penat mentally. Tapi at the end of the day, you feel fulfilled lah, cause you actually help people lah, help to save life, okay? Not like this, tapi seriously, help to save life. So kalau niat tu memang nak tolong orang, niat tu tahu macam memang nak tolong orang, bukan nak tolong pocket, then you can go for it. Tapi kalau you want to make money for being a doctor, I would suggest to look elsewhere lah, because that's not why we become doctors in the first place.
Okay, cool advice.
But Asia mindset kan, dia orang punya doktor. It's not true, guys. It's not true. Kita orang ada contract dah sekarang. So, kita orang kan contract tu.
Contract
doctors.
Yeah,
so in Malaysia kan, we are, I don't want to say anything. So, please, yeah, pray for all our patients. Pray for our people, COVID, and yeah, and the doctors.
Yeah, hopefully, hopefully. Alright, okay, so that's all from all of us. So, ada rezeki, jumpa lagi. Bye.